Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Talk Time. You know, normally my messages are encouraging. I try to be encouraging to everybody. And I normally encourage you to like go for your dreams and be a blessing to other people, or to be the best person you can possibly be. But today, I want to have a little bit more of a weightier message. And all I can do is lovingly present this stuff to you. And you know what? It's not even stuff. This is life or death information right here. And hopefully it will transform you in your way of thinking, in your way of living. And again, all I can do is lovingly present, like I tell my children all the time, you know, because they're old enough to make their own choices and decisions. So I always say that all I can do is present this to you. You do with it what you want. So same way in this case here. And, you know, some may think that it's too weighty for them when we talk about the great exchange. And when I say the great exchange, I'm talking about the work of the cross, the work that Jesus did for us. And again, some may think that it's too weighty for them to even think about or to even deal with, because they will have to deal with the things that's going on within them. And they may not fully understand the gospel. So hopefully maybe I can clarify this in a compact form, because we can't take a whole hour, which I could talk about Jesus forever. But I want to just kind of compact the gospel for you so you can understand and maybe even accept Christ in your life if you haven't done that yet. I heard a speaker say once, there are two kinds of people in the world. One type of people are the ones that have found God, and the other group are the ones that are looking for God. And you may say, well, Miss Tennia, there may not be a whole bunch of people looking for God. Believe me, they are. They are. And they mask it. What they do is they do a lot of drinking and drugging or sex. They mask it with what needs to be fulfilled by Jesus. Now, I have some good news for you, though. You know, it says in John 3:16 that God so loved the world that he gave his only son, and that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have everlasting or eternal life. You know, there was some sinful people and a holy God, and that couldn't mix. So God sent his son to take our sin. And if you understand and wholeheartedly believe, then you can have everlasting life when your time is done here upon the earth. And that's why this is called the Great Exchange, because we give our hearts to Jesus because of what he gave on the cross. And because of him, we now have granted access to the presence of the living God. And guess what? He didn't just temporarily take our sin, but he took it forever, forever. Hallelujah. Now, if this message kind of tugs at your heart a little bit, and you want to know more, please, please feel free to contact me. I know I've done a Talk Time before letting you know I was available to you, but I didn't really go into more detail. Today, I wanted to give a little bit more detail on what I mean by making Jesus your Lord and Savior, or rededicating your life to Jesus. These things are, they really are life and death. But like I said, if this does tugs at your heart, and if you want to change your life, and if you want to have everlasting life, then I want you just to repeat after me. Father God, in the name of Jesus, God, I thank you for your son, Jesus. I realize that I am a sinner and I repent. I believe you died on the cross and rose from the dead. I invite you into my heart and into my life. I receive you as my personal Lord and Savior. In Jesus' name, amen. If you said that prayer with me, then you have just received Jesus into your life and into your world, and you get to spend eternity in heaven. Now, I want you to please contact me if you have any questions. If you don't know what to do from now, from this time, now that you've said this prayer, you don't know what to do with yourself now, I would love to sit and talk with you and let you know what's next. So I love you. And thank you so much. I couldn't have this access. I have access to this media equipment that reaches so many people. And I felt the Lord kind of tugging at my own heart. Tennia, you can help change some lives with just a quick little message. So I pray that I did that today. So I thank you for watching Talk Time. I love you. Your life is going to be changed forever. And I do mean forever. Hallelujah. Thank you. This would be the day Christ would be crucified. He took his last breath. He hung his head and he died. They took my Savior down from off that rugged cross. They laid him in a tomb. It seemed all hope was truly lost. But the third day came along and brought the rhythm of life. The stone.